Hey, it's Robert and Stacy, our Data Driven Life, and this is our week in review focus on how we really got to know our technology this week.
Yes. So this week was all about getting to know technology. So we started off with our Whoops. I got my Whoop at the CrossFit Games, and so I have a few extra days of data over Robert. Your Whoop was waiting on us when we got home. So from the games, and so we've been focused on getting to know our technology. We've had Fitbits for quite a while, so we're kind of comparing and constantly understanding the technology, the language in the apps, and how they work. So we've really been focused on the Whoops, and also we both also got CGMs this week. So I think this can show somehow. Yep. There we go. So we've really been getting to know the technology that we're going to be focused on over the next, I don't know, year or so, as we go through this journey to try to go from dad bod to beach bod.
Here well, we that'd go. Be nice. Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't believe we got these things. Every single one of these items has a QR code. It has an app. And it has an additional app that you need to install in some cases.
Right,
I think I'm on app overload.
I am definitely on app overload, yes. Because, of course, we have our Fitbit app. We have the Whoop app. For Levels, Levels is one of the CGM apps that's out there. It requires me to also use the Libre Freestyle app. And then I'm also testing out January.ai at the same time as another CGM app.
And the Levels app.
CGM and January and Levels. And you're testing out the NutriSense app for your CGM.
And then if I want to track my food.
And then if we want to track our food.
Using Carb Manager.
Right.
So there's no one place. Look at that. That's just my whole home screen on my phone and everything has had to change. So that's been a huge getting used to. And there is absolutely no integration between them, or very, very, very limited integration. And because they're apps, I don't know, maybe we need to look at Zapier or something like that, but we'd be building our own integration.
Yeah.
We got enough to focus on right now, but not a lot of integration.
No. And particularly, so if we want to track our macros, right, then we're going to need to use one app. If we want to, of course, be tracking our blood glucose and seeing where we're at with that, we've got a different app. Sleep and recovery time is all Whoop. But there are still some data points from Fitbit that I really like to take a look at as well. So we're going to be in app hell for a while, I believe. And I think that's just part of the maturing of the industry as these apps do start to mature. And particularly the CGM apps are not as mature. They're newer to the market. As they mature, I think more of those integrations will occur and it will get easier with time.
So we've been through a week in a couple of days. What have been your initial thoughts? I know I got some ideas, but what have been your initial thoughts that you've had?
So sleep and recovery has been really interesting to watch because, you know, while I knew sleep was important, I have to say that other than, you know, looking at my Fitbit to see what my sleep score was, I really, and I would look to see how much deep sleep I got, but I really wasn't as focused on it, and I think the Whoop has made me a lot more focused on sleep and recovery, and so we've had some challenges around sleep.
We've never had a consistent bedtime. We're pretty consistent about when we get up, but that going to bed, that getting ready for bed, the focus on creating an environment for sleep, and then for me, when it's the middle of the night and I wake up. I can fall asleep pretty quick.
You fall asleep super fast.
What happens at 1 a.m., at 4 a.m. when you're awake and your mind starts having that back channel, that back talk? How do you get back to sleep and get back into the phases of recovery? So that was pretty interesting. For me, I was interested. I've had the CGM, the glucose monitor, for a couple days. First time I really did an intense workout with it and seeing the spike that went up, and then when I got home, the drop off. And I recognized that drop off period would have been a time when I would have been reaching for the can of soda, the energy drink that was full of sugar, looking for that caffeine. I got terrible problems with caffeine. So for me, that was something that was very interesting. And then seeing the response to our meal last night, that was very, almost a keto based type of meal, very low carb, and what it did. How about for you?
Well, we had a really interesting thing happen with my CGM. So when we put my CGM on, which was almost as soon as we got home from the CrossFit Games, I still had a few bug bites, but I didn't realize it. And so when we put the kind of the adhesive bandage over the top of it to make sure it stayed in place, it was on top of some bug bites. Yeah, so I went to change it out after a week, and I really had some kind of, you know, it kind of took away a little skin, just bug bite skin. So I had a little blood, and so I thought I would leave it off for a bit. Well, we went for a walk. It's Florida. It's hot. It's sticky. So my CGM didn't have any cover on it at all. It was just the CGM itself. And so it started, you know, Robert noticed that it was coming away from my skin. So it was not seated in place anymore. Of course, we're, I don't know, a mile away from home. So I went ahead and pushed it back in. Well, the readings that I got after that were, you know, just didn't seem accurate. You know, it was showing that my blood sugar was really low, like hypoglycemic, for an extended period of time, despite, you know, me eating some carbs, despite, you know, dietary things that should have brought it back up. So
I think you were a 40 right after dinner.
Yeah,
which didn't make any sense at all.
So we decided to go ahead and take that one off, put the second one on the other arm, and so we could see that the filament was bent. So note to self, make sure that we always keep something on to keep it in place. And if you can't use an adhesive patch, you might also just wrap it in some gauze or something like that. But you do need something to keep it in place if you're going to be sweating. So
I can see why New Year's resolutions are so powerful.
Okay.
There have been many times where we say, well, this upcoming Monday, well, this weekend, well, this time. And I think we did that a little bit with the CGM. I didn't have mine on yet, but I think it was a little bit of, I'm on a great diet. I just emptied everything out of my refrigerator. Boy, was it delicious. And I think we tried that the other night with the liquor cabinet as well, as to, okay, well, before we get all serious into this, let's go ahead and have one cocktail, and that leads to two, and that leads to three. And your CGM had fun with that, didn't it?
Yes. So my CGM, definitely huge spike, of course, which makes sense. And of course, with alcohol, then where the Cheez-Its looked really, really good after that. So it wasn't just the alcohol, but it was also the alcohol, and which led to reduction in inhibitions, which led to me going, yeah, screw it, I'm just gonna have some Cheez-Its too. So an unlimited amount straight out of the bag. So yes, yeah, so I definitely saw all the spikes from the alcohol. What was interesting was I actually saw two spikes from the alcohol in the middle of the night while I was sleeping. One spike up and then one spike down, and versus a monophasic spike, which would be a single one. So the good news was, from the reading that I did, the two spikes is indicative of a healthier response to an overload versus a monophasic spike. So I was like, okay, that's slightly reassuring. But at the end of the day, I was like, wow, what a roller coaster I've been putting my body on. And in particular, I would say we were drinking more days than we weren't drinking before. So, wow, what have I been doing to my body with drinking almost every day?
And right, so. For me, I didn't have the CGM on. I noticed it anecdotally in my Fitbit reading, so being awake. So when those spikes occur, whether it be the one or two or the drop, that it woke me up and I was not able to get back to sleep or had some difficulties with that. And then dealing with the fog and the haze that yeah. goes through it afterwards. So that's something.
So I would say that it's not that we're not, I don't want to be those people that don't ever drink again. Because, you know, so, but we will definitely be limiting the opportunities where we do introduce alcohol or tracking it a little more closely to see how it impacts us.
So were you pleased with the week, getting to know the stuff and the wearables and the technology and the apps?
I was. I feel like I'm a lot more comfortable with the technology. It was a lot of reading about, you know, understanding terminology and things like that. Overall, I lost a little over 4 pounds, which I'm very sure was all a bunch of water weight from the travel where I had, you know, oh, my ankles were so puffy and everything like that. So, you know, no, do I think I lost 4 pounds of fat? Oh, heck no, I didn't. You know, but I definitely am trending in the right direction now. Yeah. So what about you?
I think I lost all the weight from the cheese curds that I ate when I was in Wisconsin.
No word,
that was good. Just needed to take care of that. So I'm going to be a little bit more focused. So that's the current week that we went through.
Yep.
What are you focused on next week? I know what I'm focused on. It's definitely going to be on tracking macros. How about yourself?
Yeah, definitely, which means the scale is going to be out on the cabinet at all times.
Two scales. I know we talk about multiple apps, but we also have two scales. One in the weight scale, but then the second one, I guess it is a weight scale as well, but actually weighing the food so that you can see, enter in the information as to how much you had, how many ounces, how many cups, those types of things.
Yeah, yep. And I think we will probably actually get all the way down to the gram level, which is more accurate than the ounce level. So that we can really track those. We're going to be using Carb Manager is the app that we're going to be using to track our macros in. Now we have different, we used Carb Manager to calculate what our macros should be, and that was based on a 5% of our total calories in carbs, which means that you and I have very different numbers for our macros. Interestingly enough, most ketogenic diets will tell you that you need to be strictly below 20 grams. Robert's going to be at 31 grams. I'm going to be at 16, which is even below the 20. I'm very interested in seeing if you can get into ketosis at 31.
Yeah.
Which is highly possible, you know, given that you are a big guy. And so, you know, your requirements, your body's requirements are different than mine. So I'm going to be interested in that. I'm also going to be watching the CGM.
Okay.
So I started experimenting a little bit this week with seeing how my body reacts to foods. So in particular, my coffee, you know, I really wanted to see if my one morning cup of coffee, and of course this is really kind of two cups of coffee if you were tracking it, which I have with 2 tablespoons of cream and 2 pumps of a Tarani sugar-free syrup. I wanted to see if that impacted my blood sugar levels, and it did not. Yay, I can keep having my cup of coffee. But I'm going to be watching what foods do impact. So we're also going to be tracking our foods within our CGM.
Yeah.
Not at probably as much detail, but
more of a I had this particular meal, and it gives you a meal score afterwards. So it's looking at how did you respond to that particular meal, and then we'll look at the every 15 minutes, etc., as to what did our glucose do. I want to do the same thing with Keto Chow, because if I've got to stay below 31. You really 31. That's one soda, I think.
Oh.
Or half a soda. So being able or a sugared energy drink. So.
Oh yeah.
Being able to track that, I got this sweet tooth back here. I was born with it, or I think the sweet tooth's right there. And being able to track a keto chow, so during the day I can have that and get some of the flavor. So that's something.
Are you going to experiment with different fat sources in your keto chow?
Not yet. I want to keep it pretty basic, and I also know. Although I do need to experiment with some of the fat sources, meaning that we make the keto chow with a melted butter or making it with a heavy cream, the reactions to dairy, those types of things.
So avocado oil.
This is some of the tracking that also will go on, but I want to keep it pretty stable because I know how my body has reacted to having the butter as a source. The other thing that I'm really going to be focused on, I did not realize how difficult it is to get 8 hours of sleep.
Yes. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. I mean, I think we have a lot of challenges around that, and I agree. That's an area I really want to focus on this next week. So we typically, we put a mini split, which is a individual kind of air conditioner in our bedroom, so we could purposely adjust the temperature in our bedroom differently than the temperature in the rest of the house. Mm-hmm. And in part because we wanted to, you know, conserve energy and not be cooling the entire house down at night. So we've been keeping it around 69 degrees at night. And so I think I'd like to experiment with dropping the temperature down and to see what that does. We also have more ambient light than I would like in the bedroom. Mm-hmm. From a couple of windows, we've done a pretty good job with like the immediate area around our bed, but
now, why does every power strip have to come with a blaring light that's on it? So gotta
I
be researching that.
I will have my black electrical tape out to stick electrical tape over the top of all the lights. So we're going to work on that, work on cooling the bedroom down to see what that does. Also, we sleep with our two pups, and so we may start working on training them to sleep, not with us, but sleep somewhere else, because we know that that definitely interrupts our sleep as well.
That might be as difficult to give up as the sodas, the sugary drinks, or the cocktail here and there. Yet, you know, they're like family, they're our kids, and we treat them like that. So yeah, definitely on the improving sleep, looking at a set bedtime. We're usually pretty good at getting up. So becoming more of the calendar type of aspect, or looking at it as a schedule, setting some alarms. I need to work on falling asleep. I fall asleep like that.
Yeah.
How do I fall back asleep if I've woken up in the middle of the night, if there's some other ambient noise, traffic, those types of things that I hear? Okay, I was trying to be kind there. So how do you do that? A lot of the other apps that are out there, the Calm or those types of Headspace, now you're having to grab your phone. You're having to look at your phone. I've been wearing an eye mask. Well, when I put the eye mask back over after I've been looking at the phone, even though I have the blue light settings on it, I still see the outline of the phone in my vision. So how to be able to fall back asleep, that's something that I've got to learn and be able to go through.
Well, I think that's a lot for us to focus on next week, but you know, it's all gonna be very data driven. We're going to be tracking it and measuring it, and we can let you know how it went next Sunday.
So I think this is the point where we're supposed to tell them. We probably should have told them beforehand. Please hit subscribe. That'll let you know when we got new. Hit click the bell. It'll let you know when we got new videos coming out. And if you are using any of these tools, leave a comment. Let us know. We would love to hear your feedback on the Whoop, on the CGM, on a keto diet.
Yeah, any tricks for integrating all these apps? We would particularly love to hear those.
That would be fantastic. So we'll catch you on the next video.
Have a great week.